from the high desert and the great American Southwest and pumping out to you loud and crystal clear from sea to shining sea and all the way from pole to freezing pole. And everywhere there is in between, you know it is always my honor and great pleasure to welcome you, well, to the Kingdom of Nye. And I am your host tonight, Heather Wade. Thank you so much for tuning in tonight, because boy, do I ever have a story for you. Well, tonight is Friday night, and that means unscreened open lines all night long. That means it's me and you all night long, right? As we rage through the night, I certainly hope you're ready to take a ride, because boy, do we got something to talk about. Oh, do we ever have something to talk about. You guys, well, if you were listening last night, you're probably wondering what happened in the final hour of the program. I'm here tonight to explain all of that to you. And, well, I'll just come clean with all of you. I really contemplated not coming on tonight at all. I really did. After I saw what I saw last night off the air, I contemplated for many, many hours whether I should even come on and talk about it at all. In fact, I have been advised by other people not to talk about it. And I thought and thought and thought to myself, well, what are we going to do? We've got a show to do. We've got a very interesting story. The problem is, here's the problem, everybody. This is the problem. I'm not quite sure you're going to believe me. Now, I can tell you the exact truth as I know it from my point of view, what happened here in the high desert in Pahrump. I can tell you what happened. Whether you believe me or not is another story. And like I said, I contemplated long and hard whether I should even tell this on the air. Because, just for a lot of reasons, really, what I saw last night really, really has stopped me in my tracks. Now, if you weren't listening last night, well, we were talking about afterlife encounters with a good friend of mine, Dr. Carla Wills Brandon, really special lady on this earth. Dr. Carla Wills Brandon, Art used to call her the death lady, because that's what she talks about. She talks about all aspects of death and dying and the afterlife, and she is one of the best people, at least in our country, and I don't know about the rest of the world, but she is certainly one of the best people to talk to about these sort of things. I mean, she has seen it from top to bottom and from left to right. She has seen it all. And it was strange, because we've had a run of pretty flawless programs, right? Technically. I saw somebody online made a comment, well, it seems like the broadcast is fraught with technical problems. Actually, no, it isn't. We've been doing just fine on our broadcast. But last night, you know, it was just really weird. I always kind of get a sense on how shows are going to go, usually by knowing a little something about the guest or just kind of observing how the prep goes before a show. You can get an idea, you know, a gut feeling on how this show is going to go. And it started with the sound check. Well, here's a little behind the scenes. A lot of people want to get a look behind the scenes on how these kind of programs are run. Well, I always do a sound check, and I always do extensive prep and research on my guests and all these sort of things. And usually a sound check will kind of tell it, you know. You got a good, smooth sound check. Things that usually go okay. Well, it was odd because, again, with Dr. Carla Wills Brandon, we've usually never had a problem with a sound check. And, you know, it just, well, I'd call her on Skype and we'd try that and it wouldn't work, or she wouldn't hear me or I couldn't hear her. And then we'd try another method on Skype with another headset and things like this. And then she went from one computer to another computer. And finally, you know, at the last minute, I said, good old fashioned landline. Let's get on that. And speaking of technical problems, now all of a sudden I've got audio in one ear. There we go. Now I got audio in both ears. Okay. Strange. And it's going to get weirder. It is. We haven't even got to it just yet. So anyhow, we finally got Dr. Brandon on a on just a landline, got her on and started doing the program. And I kind of heard her phone acting a little strange, and I thought to myself, well, we can hear her, and she sounds good, but isn't that odd? And then at one point in the program, we completely lost her and had to get her back. And this always raises my eyebrow. You know, I always take note of something like that, which is odd, very odd, for a landline, that is. Usually doesn't ever happen on a landline. All right, so we're doing the program. We're doing okay. We're doing pretty good. We're getting into some very good material as far as the subject goes, afterlife encounters, afterlife communication, visitations, these sort of things. Like I said, Dr. Brandon is, I would say, in the top five of people to talk to about these kind of things. Probably top three. I don't know who the other two are, but Dr. Brandon is definitely way up there. So we were getting such good information from her. And then I went ahead and opened up the phone lines, and that was going well. We were getting some really interesting calls. I had the looking glass just full of stories from those of you out there. And we go to a break. We go to our midnight break. And boy, I just couldn't believe it at the time that 3 hours had gone by just like that quick. But it had. And so we run into our break, and I'm thinking, all right, things are going well. Again, behind the scenes kind of stuff. You know, as a host, I'm sort of having a different line of thought on is the show going well or not than probably a listener out there. So I realize, okay, we've got our guest on. We're doing very good. We're going back and forth. Good conversation. The audience is clearly engaged in the subject. I look at my phone. My phone is absolutely full. Every line I have on the phone. I think the only line at that moment that was not ringing was the international Skype line, which, by the way, is open tonight. We'll get to that later. So every phone line is full. Our guest is good. We're doing very, very good. And I go to the break, and I've got my next bumper queued up. So much has happened in the last 24 hours. I couldn't really tell you what that bumper was, but I get the bumper queued up, and off we go, and click, it happens. The power goes out. Now, there's no reason for my power to go out. Only my power went out. Nobody else around here's power went out. My power goes out. Well, the UPS backups are supposed to keep us on just long enough so we can let everybody know, okay, I think the power's gone out, and we may have to end the broadcast early. That's why those backups are in place, to give us a little more time so that we don't simply get cut off. Well, that's exactly what happened. At the stroke of midnight, and I'm telling you, I'm looking at a BRG Precision atomic clock, and at 12:00, I mean right at midnight, boom, it went off. And of course, I start looking around. Okay, what can I do? What can I fix here? I know the studio quite well, so what can I fix here? I start looking around, and I realize, well, the UPS that our internet router is connected to, that seems to be the bug. That seems to be the problem. Okay, so then the power comes back on in the house, right? In the studio, the power comes back on, and I'm trying to reset the UPS power backup. It is not responding. It won't even let me get into the menu, which there's no explanation for that. So now we're off the air, and I get on the phone with Ira Robinson, our network manager, and I start telling him the situation because he needs to know. You can't have dead air. So he needs to know. And I'm thinking about our radio stations. I'm thinking about the callers that are on the phone. Of course, I'm thinking about Dr. Brandon's probably wondering what is going on. Everybody wants to know what is going on. So, okay, so I start looking around. Well, this UPS does not seem to be responding. So, okay, here's what we'll do. We will unplug the UPS from the wall, plug it back in. Usually that will reset it sometimes. I've done that once before. Usually you just hit the button on the menu, you hit reset, the thing comes back online, and boom, you're back in business. That is not what happened. So I unplug the UPS from the wall, plug it back in now that we have power, and no dice. The UPS comes back on, but the thing isn't online. It's showing me that it does have battery power stored into it, so I know that it's not the batteries. I know a lot of people have said, well, the batteries on the inside of the thing, they fail now and then. Okay, sure, they can, they do. Sometimes. But if it can hold a charge, it doesn't have really an explanation as to why the thing isn't delivering power to the things that are plugged into it. All right, so that's going on. We try then unplug, everything that's plugged into the backup, plug that right into the wall. That will surely work, right? It's not working. No dice. One of the computers that helps me run the show over here plugged into the same source of power, not coming on. The internet router also not coming on. Now we're plugged directly into the wall and the power strip is telling me it does have power. There's other things plugged into that power strip that are receiving power. So now it's starting to get really weird. Okay, very weird. So I'm on the phone with Ira Robinson and he says, well, look, here's what we can do. I can put you on from here. And I said, well, Ira, all I have is a cell signal. And not much of one, because I really am living on the edge of nowhere out here, on the very edge of any sort of cell signal. This is why I use the Wi-Fi for my phone. Well, I managed to at least have enough signal to get on the phone and stay on the phone with Ira Robinson, our network manager over at the LNM Radio Network. And he puts me on the air and he says, look, you can give an explanation to everybody this way. So I get on the air and I'm telling everybody, okay, got this problem with the UPS power backup. The power went out. On and on. I have no explanation for this. I'm hitting the button, the reset button on that UPS, just frantically getting no luck at all. So, okay. I give my explanation. I apologize to everyone and proceed to figure it out. And I'm still on the phone with Ira. And unbeknownst to me, the show audio was still being recorded at the time. And now I'm very mystified. How can one thing be plugged in to a power strip, be receiving power, and another thing being plugged in to the same power strip and not getting power? It doesn't make any sense. Doesn't make any sense to me at all. So I said, all right, Ira, here, we got to figure out how to fix this so we can get on the air tomorrow night. And this is the part that I don't want to tell you. I really don't. I do not feel comfortable telling you this. But what was the conversation last night? The conversation last night was all about, we've got to get past our own uncomfort, discomfort, when it comes to these things. Right? And I have always told you guys the straight truth. I've always been completely open with you, told you everything, even hard things that are difficult for me to get out loud. I've pretty much opened my life to all of you and turned my life into your entertainment. So I had to think really hard about this, but here is what I saw. And I don't think you're going to believe me. You can make of it what you will. But this is what I saw, and it's going to take a little bit of telling, because there's a little background here. Now, 3 or 4 weeks ago, I was wanting to make sure that the whole broadcast was just rock solid, right? The network was doing things, I'm doing things here in the studio to make sure we deliver you a stable product Monday through Friday from 9 to 1 a.m. Pacific time. And I woke up one morning and the internet was out. And I thought, oh, I got to go fix that. We're on tonight. I got to go fix that. And this, again, was about 3 or 4 weeks ago. And if I don't tell you this, the rest of it is not going to make sense. So please bear with me here. So it was about 11 in the morning. I got up, no internet. So I come in to the studio to figure out why, because the router in the studio is my whole internet for the whole house. So I come in and I notice, oh, look at this. For some reason, this area of the studio, this UPS backup, it isn't working. It's not delivering power the way it should. So I go and I check the UPS. It's fine. It was fine at that time. And I got it to come back on. I got into the menu, reset it, got it back on. It's delivering power. And I go and I have to pull this desk out from the wall just a little bit because there's only about an inch of room back there. So I pull the desk out of the wall and I find the power strips that are back there and I verify, you know, do these things still work? And in fact, they were not working. I don't know. Did they blow a fuse? I don't know what happened, but those power strips were no longer working. So I went and I got I've got all kinds of equipment laying around the house just in case I need it. So I grabbed a couple of brand new high quality power strips, plugged them in, and plugged all the equipment into that. And lo and behold, we have internet and everything is fine. Well, at the time, and again, this is the part that's hard for me to talk about because I don't know what you're going to make of this. You know, you're all welcome to call all night long tonight and give me your theories, because by the time you hear this, you're going to have plenty. Okay. Well, at the time, what I had done, just like anybody would do, as I'm unplugging things from the power strips that are now not functional, I'm going to replace those. I unplug the lamp and I put the plug to the lamp by the lamp. I unplug the internet router and I put that plug right on top of the router and everything else I was unplugging to remind me, okay, this is the plug for this and this is the plug for that, so that when I hook it all up, I know what's what. And I'm telling you the God's honest truth on the life of my cats, on the life of everybody I love. That internet router cable with the big, you know, wall wart on it was intact at the time. Nothing unusual about it whatsoever. Just an internet router cable, power cable, right? So I plug everything back in. The new power strips work. Everything's fine. Off we go. We did 2 or 3 weeks, I don't know, 3 or 4 weeks now, of shows without a hitch, just fine. Okay, so now we need to fast forward to last night for this to make sense to you. Okay, so Ira and I have tried a couple of things, and I'm thinking, all right, well, what we're going to do, we're going to bypass the UPS backup. Maybe I'll plug that into the wall. We'll get ourselves on the air. That way, we'll finish out the show. Okay, so I plug it into the wall, and like I said, the router is not coming on. The looking glass computer is not coming on, and yet another computer hooked up to the same power strip is coming on. So I'm very confused, and so is Ira. And Ira and I are on the phone, and he's giving me a whole bunch of possibilities. Well, maybe it's this. You could check that. You know, he's trying to help. And so I get back there, and I look, and I'm thinking, okay, take the internet router plug-in, and plug that into something that we definitely know is receiving power, and off we go. So I look at the internet router cable, power cable, the wall wart cable, and what I saw, I have no way to explain to you. I don't. Again, this is why I was contemplating not coming on tonight, or simply not telling you this. Like I said, other people advised me not to talk about this. So here we are. So I look back there. I go to put my hand on the wall wart plug for the internet router. And I notice something that is absolutely impossible. It just cannot be. The power cable coming out of the router is simply hanging there. And the cable is cut. The cable is severed. It's hanging there with its copper wires exposed. Now, I cannot explain to you how that happened. I was on the air. I can tell you right now, I have no interest in kicking myself off the air. I can also tell you right now, my headset cable doesn't even reach that far, and I have no interest in tampering with my own studio. I don't. There's no reason for that. I don't benefit from that. In fact, all that does is make us look bad. Makes us look like, you know, we can't keep a show on the air. And you know I don't want that. So I look back there. I see that this internet router cable is simply dangling, hooked up to nothing. I go to grab the wall wart plug-in from the power strip, and I notice that this also, well, it's hooked up to nothing. It's got its wires exposed. The cable is cut. And I look at it very carefully, and then I notice something else. It jumps right out at me. You know, this does not look like it was just done tonight. You know, when you cut a cable and you expose the wires on the inside for the first time, they're very shiny, and they look brand new because they've been covered up inside the insulation of the cable. Well, this looked old. It looked like it had been like that for quite some time. And I'm telling you, I pulled that out 3 or 4 weeks ago, and it was a perfectly fine, nothing wrong with it whatsoever, boring old cable. And I was the only one who saw that at that time. Now, I could take a picture of this router cable for you if you want to look at it. What you're going to see is, well, you're going to look at it and you're going to say, well, somebody did that a long time ago. That's why it looks like that. And I can't emphasize it enough. I saw it myself. I unplugged it myself. And that cable was nothing of note at the time. Nothing of note at all. And yet somehow the thing is severed. Now, again, are you going to believe me? Are you not going to believe me? Here we are talking about, is the afterlife real? This was my question for Open Lines for tonight. Is the afterlife real? Well, that's a good question, isn't it? And what I'd like to do, because there's more even to this than this, actually, is I'd like to bring on our network manager, Ira Robinson. We do have to head into a break here in a couple of minutes, but I want to get this started with Ira. I want you to hear it from him, because when all this was going on, I was on the phone with him, and he heard my voice. He heard it. And I would like to bring Ira Robinson on from the LNM Radio Network. He is our network manager. He pretty much runs the whole show at the LNM Radio Network. Ira, it is an absolute pleasure to have you join me on such a weird night as this. I do understand we got a break coming up, but would you care to tell, or at least start telling everybody what you experienced from your point of view?
I will say it was definite quantum oddness for sure, Heather. By the way, hello, and I'm glad to finally be here on your show with you. This is a very interesting time for me. But yes, you had called me, and I heard the confusion in your voice when we were first trying to figure out just what was going on and how upset you were about, holy cow, my power's knocked out. What am I going to do here? What's happening? Trying to figure it out, running through everything. And then when you ran across what happened to that particular wire, you were frightened. I will say flat out, you were frightened about it, because I know there were all kinds of things that were going through your mind at that moment in time. What the heck is going on here?
The principal thing, and I wonder if people out there are picking up on this or have put it together. The principal thing is, Ira, how long was that cable severed, that power cable severed? And, okay, so the cable is severed and the power goes out at the same time. But how long has that cable been severed? And how exactly have we been able to be on the air for the past 3 or 4 weeks at all?
Exactly. And a couple of people have spoken in the chat room there. They were wondering, did it just get dislodged or something like that? No. It was not just dislodged. This power cable was severed right in the, I mean, it was like away from the wall wart and everything, severed away from each other.
Yes.
No, it was not a simple dislodging. That is for sure.
No. Yeah. And people are going to have a lot of questions, and this is why I wanted to bring you on, Ira. We got to run into a break, but would you hang on the line here?
I will indeed, yes.
Because there's much more to this. I mean, things were not just happening to me. There were things happening, well, in other places on the network. And I feel that if I'm going to give you the story, well, I ought to give you the whole story. And when you hear what Ira has to say, again, make of it what you will. I'm simply telling you, filling you in on what happened in the last hour, last night. And you and I can talk about this for the rest of the night. Now, you've gotten about half of the story. When we come back, Ira Robinson and I will give you the rest of it, mostly Ira. I'm Heather Wade. This is the Kingdom of Nye. We're on the air at this moment. And activity is afoot, ladies and gentlemen. That's about the best thing I can tell you. We'll be right back. Harvey used to say, right? Well, the number's to the program. If you do want to call in, if you do have a theory about what has happened last night, I'd love to hear it. The number is 952-225-5278. If you're a first-time caller, we got a line just for you. That's 775-285-5800. You can find all the phone numbers to the program over at thekingdomofnye.com or at artbelllegacy.com. They both go to the same place. And now I've got to get back to Ira Robinson, who is the network manager over at the LNM Radio Network. And he has, well, another side of the story to tell. Like I said, it was not just what's going on here with me. There were other things going on, but I want him to finish right where he left off there at, Ira, you were welcome back, by the way. You were on the phone Hello. With me. And we were, I remember this moment very, very clearly. You were saying, check this and check that and try this and try that. Or what about this and what about that? And I stopped you and I said, Ira, I think we've got a bigger problem here.
Yes. Yes. And I heard the tenor in your voice was, it was definitely a mix of fear and confusion. That is for sure. You had no idea what you were seeing, to say the least. And when you told me what you were looking at, the first thought that went through my mind was, how exactly did this occur? You know, how exactly could this have happened?
Right. I just got a message here from Jeff in Pensacola, who says, well, we've confirmed that you have cats. Now, I want to rule that out while we're talking about what could have caused this. I know you have your ideas. That's a real easy one. Like I said earlier, there's only about an inch of room back there. There's no room for cats to even get a paw anywhere close. And I don't really let them in the studio anyhow. Sorry, Ira, go right ahead.
Yeah, no, you're absolutely right. And in fact, that was a couple of things that people had brought up is, were the wires chewed? No, they were not chewed. It was a severing that ended up occurring. And that's where the big issue lies. Here's the thing. Okay, so I've spoken to a couple of people myself about it. And one of the suggestions was that somebody got in, cut the wire, and got out. Now, the trouble with that...
Yeah, I'd like that, some company. Yeah, that'd be nice.
The trouble with that explanation is this. Here you are sitting in this room within a closed house, and the room itself is closed off from the rest of the house. The door is shut. You've got the air conditioning running, so on and so forth. You would know if that door was opened. Not only would you know that the door was open by the change in air pressure and the change in the way that things are, but the cats would have been right there into the room because they want to be in that room with you.
Yes.
So
yes,
they did not enter into the room. The door was closed the whole time that all of this was going on. When you lost power, the door was closed. So if somebody did get into your house, that means that they would have had to slip into your house without you noticing, would have had to slip into your room that you were currently broadcasting in without you noticing, and get underneath the desk that's sitting right by you without you noticing to cut the wire, then sneak back out of the room, close the door, sneak out of your house, close that door, all within the span of, what would you estimate, 45, 50 seconds worth of time?
Yeah. Oh, and not only that, but this is a clever ninja, because the person would have to get in, do all that, and also age those wires, because I'm telling you, it looks like something that's old, and it wasn't. That's the part that I'm never going to be able to prove that
exactly
to anybody, Ira.
That's where, again, the quantum strangeness of all of this comes in, because here you have this situation. Again, you know, if somebody was able to do that, they're one heck of a ninja. And I would like to meet this guy just so I can shake his hand and say, good job.
Yeah, well played.
On your professionalism, you know.
Certainly well played. And I mean, you know, like I said, at the moment, I told you everything that was going through my head at the moment. Here we're coming back from a break. We've got a great guest tonight, a friend of mine. Yeah. We've got a phone full of calls. You know, if you want to make me a happy girl, fill up my phone and give me a good guest and put me on the air. I mean, that's all you have to do. That's Christmas morning to me. So that's all I was thinking about. The last thing I would ever think about is, let me yank the internet cable. Yeah, that's going to do us a whole lot of favors. You know,
real professionalism. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That's going to make my affiliates happy. That's going to make the network happy and the listeners and everybody. You know, that's really going to be a big thrill for all of us. And the fact that it happened, I mean, right at the stroke of midnight. Exactly
at midnight.
I mean, not 12:03, 12:00, Ira.
Yeah.
It Boom.
Was, and
that's
again, part of that real strangeness that was occurring, because we know a lot of weird things can happen right at that midnight hour. That's for sure. Now, aside to this story, and this is sort of getting into what happened before what happened to you, and I'm not saying that this is exactly how can I put this? I'm not saying that it's related. I'm not saying that it's not related, but it's a very strange coincidence at the least. Okay. As far as this part of it goes, I'm sorry. You were trying to say something. Go ahead.
No. It's all right. I wasn't talking. You were probably reading my mind, because what I was thinking was, you know, here I'm going through this, and then at the same time, there's other things going on with engineers at the network.
Yes.
We'll tell them this other part, which, by the way, everybody, I just found out today.
Yes, you didn't know about this before. So here's what happened earlier in the evening. So one of our ways that we do things is through a relay. And the person that was running the relay at that time, I had to take things over for them at 12:26 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. So it would have been 9:26, your normal broadcast, 9:26 Pacific Time.
Exactly now, when I bring Dr. Carla Wills-Brandon on. That's every night. That's when I bring my guest on.
So it was right when you were bringing the guest on that this occurred. Their system literally fried out. The power strips that they use to run their computers, run their modems, everything literally lit on fire, and their place went dark. Right when you were bringing this woman on. And so I ended up having to take things over. And then at the stroke of midnight, boom, what happened to you happened to you. Mm-hmm. So again, I'm not saying that they are absolutely related, but if they aren't, what a heck of a coincidence, to say the least.
Well, see, you had brought this up earlier today, because, by the way, everybody, we've been having meetings on this and trying to get to the bottom of this, but to prevent anything like this happening in the future. And the reason that I am here on tonight, when I had half a mind to not be, is because I said, hey, once I'm back, I'm back, and that's it. Just because you're having a hard day, that doesn't mean you get to just not go on the air. You have to go on. That's the promise that I've made, and so that's what I'm trying to live up to here. But it all has to do with power. And what were we talking about last night at the exact moment, even, that this happened? Dr. Brandon, Will Charles Brandon was talking about, well, electricity is the one thing that is so easy for them to manipulate. They'll manipulate yes. things. And I told for the first time, I really don't know, I don't think I've told this on the air before, about the power fluctuations that I have every day. And that has happened ever since April 13th. I haven't been talking about it because I really don't know what to say. But all of this has to do with electricity and power, and that's what we were talking about. And I just, Ira, I just, this is so strange. I mean, it's fine when these kind of weird things happen to me off the yes. air. You know, I can kind of digest that and get past it, and we'll get on the air, and we'll do an honest show, and off we go. But when it happens in the middle of the show, about afterlife encounters, which was the title of the show, and it all has to do with electricity and it all has to do with power. I mean, Ira, you know, you've written a book, haven't you, about these kind of encounters. I mean, based on your research and your experience, is there anything you can offer us right now to help understand what happened? I mean, is this all just little accidents that seem to happen in one night for no reason? Or,
well, you know, to be honest with you, we're dealing with things that we cannot explain. I mean, that's the whole reason why they are paranormal, right? We can't explain them through normal means. We have to try to figure out, though, a scientific means for these kind of mechanisms to occur. What we have been able to figure out is that the likelihood of spirits being electromagnetic in nature is high. Like that is a very high likelihood. We can't say for sure because we haven't been able to measure it yet, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, we have to be honest with people. But the likelihood of it being that way is excessively high. Now, we also know that if you follow the laws of thermodynamics, energy can neither be created or destroyed. It just changes form. You know, it changes its effects. And I think that spirits are, you know, a form of energy. You know, they are that energetic form. Now, that being said, again, if they are electromagnetic in nature, then they can manipulate things that are in the electromagnetic frequencies. And I think that they can do it very easily. If you look at all of the different people that have researched this topic, every one of them will admit that, yes, in the presence of spirits, there are electrical problems that happen. There are electrical phenomena that happen. Look at EVPs. I mean, that's a perfect example. Mm-hmm. They're manipulating, you know, the frequency, the sound frequencies to be able to create sounds. So there's so many different possibilities, but the best explanation is that something electromagnetic did absolutely occur with all of this. And again, you know, taking the two examples separately, you can say, yeah, okay, they're two separate examples. They're not related at all. But then you think about it, the show itself was talking about how spirits are paranormal or are electromagnetic in nature. And you have two people or two systems, two entire setups that are completely different setups, by the way.
On the
across the country.
Yeah.
You know, on all the way across the country from each other, experienced extreme power issues on the same evening during an hour and a half period of time. Explain that. You know, how do you explain that in a physical kind of way? It's very difficult to do so. Now, again, you know, spirits, I'll tell you that I'm one of those weird people. I can see them. I hear them. You know, I know when they're there. I've had a lot of different experiences over the years, and a lot of them have been very much in the electromagnetic sort of manipulation of things. When they're present, you'll see like your lights start to fuzz or brighten up a little bit or dim some. Again, they mess with like your radios and all of that kind of stuff. I mean, all different kinds of things like this happen all the time when it comes to that realm.
Well, you know, there's that question. Well, there's there's a big question for tonight. I mean, my question, and by the way, the network knows this. I had come up with our question for tonight's open lines last Sunday, which is,
yes.
You know, I didn't know all this stuff was going to happen last night. And here our question is the afterlife real? Well, yeah. That's something we can chew on for tonight if you'd like. But then the question comes down to this, Ira. Is the afterlife trying to get our attention here, or, and forgive me for this, forgive me for this, because I've been advised from a lot of people, and I don't know that, like, not everybody has given me permission to drop their name, so I'm not sure that I want to do that, but I've been advised from a few people out there that perhaps something might be trying to stop me.
That's the other side of the coin. Yes, that's the other side of the coin. Is there something or someone out there, you know, some group of someone maybe out there that has decided to use some kind of methodology to bring your show to a halt in any kind of physical way that they possibly can? For example, I just got a message from someone who wanted to bring up something that they have talked about on occasion, that there is cloaking technology that could allow someone to do exactly what we were just describing about being able to come into your room without you noticing, severing the wire and getting back out again without your awareness. There are a lot of different kinds of techs that are there that we don't really have a full handle on, and yet the patents are there for these kind of things. It's possible. It's possible.
Well, I just wonder, you know, if there's a way to tamper with someone's power remotely like that. I just don't know. But
could be.
You know,
I'd love to hear from callers about it. You know, if maybe a caller out there has had experience in this kind of a field that they've been exposed to information about that kind of tech, you know, I mean, that'd be great to know. I'd love to hear that kind of thing. Or if other people out there have experienced the paranormal side, you know, maybe something paranormal that's happened that was very similar in nature, where you're seeing wires getting severed and, you know, all different kinds of stuff like that. You know, your power strip literally lights on fire, you know,
out of nowhere.
I mean, all kinds of things possible.
My
really.
God, it's just, you know, it's just amazing. But, you know, I've always told all of you at the network the truth, even when it's not something any of us want to hear. I remember breaking your heart. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Telling you that
we've never once lied to us in any way, shape, or form. You have always been absolutely upfront and honest with us in everything, bad days and good. Every bit of it, you've been very honest with us about. And I was there with you on the phone as all of this stuff was happening, real time. You can't get more real time than that without me being literally right there in the room with you.
Yeah, and looking, you know, through a camera at the same things I'm looking at. And, you know, when I say I've been honest with the network, even down to the time that I had to break your heart, Ira, and tell you, well, everything's all set, but we, you know, our dump button doesn't work. We can't go on. And poor Ira, I feel so bad about that. But good or bad or neutral, I've always been honest with the network, always told them the absolute truth. And I did the same thing last night, and I'm doing the same exact thing right now, filling you all in, giving you all the background, all the information that you need to know. And, you know, Ira, I really appreciate you coming on and filling us in on the other side of it that maybe the listeners out there did not know about. And I think maybe it'll be time to jump into calls and see what they have to say. I mean, it is open lines after all, unscreened open lines. And I appreciate this so much because, you know, what I would give for anyone to have been here with me last night to just see that cable dangling and go, wait a minute, now hang on. You know, it's like those old stories that you hear about a telephone that's not hooked up to anything or a radio that's not hooked up to anything. And it's still on, or a jukebox.
That was the thing. Because if all of this had happened previous, I mean, a couple of people had brought up, you know, maybe someone snuck in at a previous time and severed the wire and then got out and you just didn't notice it. Well, if that was the case, how were you broadcasting for 3 hours before it, you know, decided to go dead? I mean,
And all the weeks before that, like I said, I had seen it with my own eyes. I plugged it all in every night. We've been going on very confident. Yeah. Oh, yes, we're on the air pretty smooth and everything. So if anyone can explain this, I don't know, Ira. But I did warn you, didn't I, about taking on me and the show?
That there would be strange things. Yes, in fact, that was one of the first things you said within the first hour I talked to you. If you come here, there's going to be strange things occurring. And there most certainly have been strange things afoot, for sure, Heather.
Oh, yes.
I want to thank you for bringing me on here and letting me tell all of my side of it as well. And, you know, let's hear from the callers. I'd love to hear what everybody has to say about what's happened and, you know, any experiences that you guys have had out there. That'd be fantastic to know.
Oh, absolutely right. Yes. I mean, I'm sure people out there probably have had their own experiences. I mean, right before all this happened last night, we had taken a call from a young lady, a first-time caller, who was talking about a same electrical issue that she had in her house, where a lamp that didn't work just spontaneously came back on. So here we come, right full circle, back to our original question. Is the afterlife real? What happened last night? Is the afterlife trying to get our attention? Was this who we think it might have been? Or is something trying to stop me? Now, I don't know one way or the other. I am simply asking you. And if you don't believe it, you can call me and tell me, well, I just don't believe it.